this is a DB4 Aston Martin Zagato, or an Aston Martin Zagato DB4 GT, whatever. It was based in the Aston Martin DB4 chassis. It's a six-cylinder engine. It's probably nearly 300 horsepower. But the thing was, it's a Zagato-designed body. They built over 50 of these cars. And although the DB4 itself is very beautiful, this is a very special version of it. I've always loved the shape of the car. It's got a lot of muscle to it. It's a lot of shape to it, especially over the wheel arches. It gives the car a sense of power and performance.
And you said you actually got to drive this car.
Well, I haven't driven it. I've been a passenger in this car through the Hollywood Hills a number of years back. It was thoroughly enjoyable, I have to say. And I love old cars, as long as they've been put together properly.
Now, Ian, didn't you once work for Aston Martin?
I did. I did quite a few cars for Aston Martin, although other people claim they did it all. But the DB7, the Vanquish, of which, if you look at this car and look at the first Vanquish, there's a lot of similarities. I make no apologies about that. I did the DB9 and most of the Vantage V8, actually, as well.
So. What else can you tell us about, what is the Z on this car?
Well, the Z is for Zagato. Zagato was an Italian carrozzeria and still exists. Andrea Zagato is a friend of mine, he still runs the company. But really the most famous cars were during the 50s and 60s. And what they used to do in these days is build special bodies on existing chassis, such as Aston Martins and Bentleys and such likes, and Ferraris. So quite often you get this limited edition version of special bodied cars. But because there's so few of them made, these cars are worth millions now. So because of the rarity of them and because they're so beautiful, but I've always liked them. But the 50 cars built, they're all slightly different. Not one of them the same as the other, you know? And I think every time they came in the Monday morning, they kind of thought, what will we do with the next one? And they made it different from the last. So they're all slightly different.
Now, did this car have any influence on the F-Type that you designed for Jaguar?
No, maybe a little bit. Yeah, I mean, it's cute.
What one thing about
this? I just love the lines of it. I love the beautiful form and the lines that run through the car, drop into the door, and then come back up of the wheel arch. If you look at the F-Type, it has a very similar feel to it. I don't think that's so much this car in particular. It's probably more of a generic sports car thing to do. It's about wrapping the lines of the car over the wheels, and it's emphasizing the wheels of the car. But
and why do we love sports cars so much? What is it about sports cars?
Because they're indulgent, because they're very selfish, because they're an expression of your personality, because they're about you, or that's what you want, and they're about wrapping something up very beautiful in something very, very special indeed. So it's the ultimate expression of a motor car. And if you want something more room, buy a truck.